As a culinary capital and a cosmopolitan country, Singapore enjoys a variety of cuisines and an abundance of foods. But creating an environment where people never have to worry about the lack of food is not easy. The city-state must be prepared in the face of destabilizing forces to its food supply.
Disruptions are real. Disruptions can be sudden, and disruptions can be unpredictable, and disruptions can be volatile.
The Singapore Food Agency oversees food security and food safety. Besides its science-based and progressive approach to ensure food safety while protecting consumers, the agency also works hard to assure food supply for Singapore. Over 90% of Singapore's food is imported from overseas, sourced from more than 180 countries and regions. To overcome that susceptibility, the Singapore Food Agency has a multifaceted approach.
We have four security pillars which we adopt. One is import diversification. That remains an essential and key component. We continuously look at alternative sources for imports. We would also, as part of our strategy, have stockpiling because it gives us an immediate response if there are food disruptions. Local production remains an important pillar as well. We do believe that local productions can add to our supply resiliency in selected food commodities in the future. And then lastly is another pillar called global partnership, where we work with like-minded countries to look at how we could mutually have beneficial understanding that allows us to deal with food supply disruptions and resiliency of each other countries.
To overcome the challenge of land scarcity, indoor and vertical farms like this play a vital role as it's an assured and regenerative source of fresh food domestically, especially during food supply disruptions. Here, sustainable farming practices are used to maximize productivity in a limited space. It's pesticide-free and uses 90% less water than the amount used for outdoor traditional soil-grown produce.
We use a precision nutrient injector. It precisely doses the type of nutrient profiles that each crop needs. So this is something that we've developed in-house with the help of grants from SFA. And what this allows us to do is to automate all these processes. This is all done on our platform whereby we have a database of nutrient profiles, lighting profiles, and it's executed all by software.
Nestled on St. John's Island, the SFA has established the Marine Aquaculture Centre that spearheads the development of aquaculture technology. The agency also launched the National Broodstock Centre and Hatchery Development and Recognition Programme to supply genetically superior eggs and young fish, known as fingerlings, that have a higher survival and growth app rates to local farms.
To help Singapore achieve our food security goal, local aquaculture play a crucial role.
A key area of research is the selective breeding of Asian sea bass by identifying superior traits such as faster growth and increased disease resistance.
There's limited studies on tropical marine species, and what we are doing here is to understand more about the species that are commonly farmed here in this region and especially in Singapore. With all this knowledge, we can help to improve the productivities of our local farm and also have an impact with our regional countries also.
That extends to farming environment. Researchers are able to monitor conditions and analyze plankton as well as other elements in the water using the aquaculture sensing network. Such technology offering real-time data is revolutionizing farm management, making them more efficient and climate resilient. As cities worldwide grapple with food insecurity, Singapore's experience offers valuable lessons. The SFA fosters mutually beneficial partnerships to enhance food resilience in regions all over the world.
We're constantly looking at how other countries are dealing with disruptions, looking at the preparation they have made, what lessons we could draw from them, and then constantly asking, can we do things differently?
And the awareness of the need to constantly adapt and meet new evolving challenges could see Singapore stand in good stead to overcome disruptions on the horizon.